insights from the world's best medical minds. You are watching TheRightDoctors.com.
Coronavirus is not deadly. It is highly infectious. It is 10 times more infectious than the flu virus. It's an ordinary flu virus. And if you see the data, which was published, about 1,52,000 patients have been reported to be suffering from coronavirus, out of which 70% have completely recovered. The remaining 27% are in the phase of recovery all over the world. Only 3% mortality. The mortality is, or death rate is 2.5 to 3%. That too in elderly population beyond the age of 70 years. And that too who have an underlying comorbidity in the form of hypertension, diabetes, or old heart attack, or chronic kidney disease, or they are immunologically compromised. One thing is very important. The fear psychosis and panic situation which has been created all over the world, that makes the elderly people highly vulnerable. Because when they are in a panic state, there is a fear, there is an anxiety state, and which liberates a lot of stress hormones in the form of epinephrine, norepinephrine, and cortisol. And it is this cortisol which further increases the blood pressure, and epinephrine and norepinephrine. When the blood pressure is high, they are more prone to get into heart problems, and their death is all because of panic attacks. One should not have any panic attack, then the vulnerability of even death or mortality in elderly patient will also reduce. One thing is very important. We all know it originated from China. Number one, highest number of cases were seen in Wuhan. Number two, it was seen in Italy. And number three, it was seen in Iran. And number four, in South Korea. Today, almost whole world is affected by the coronavirus. But I'm sure in next 6 weeks or so, it will disappear from this planet. As the temperatures start rising, especially from Delhi or India, we'll see here, it will not be able to stand the temperature beyond 30 degrees of centigrade. And the predilection of this virus is same as other flu viruses. It affects the nasal mucous membrane, upper respiratory tract like sore throat, and it may affect the bronchi. There is one study published from Wuhan, and this study is a cardiologist perspective. And that is shown that some postmortems were performed in those patients who died because of coronavirus. And they found no evidence of heart attack, and they found no evidence of any myocarditis. But they found only some evidence of lung fibrosis because of pneumonia. So all these people who are elderly, who have comorbidities, are more vulnerable. We should take all the precautions. Precautions are very important. Personal quarantine, home quarantine, community quarantine, national quarantine, and international quarantine is the answer. When I say individual level, we should take all the precaution as individual. We should take in the home for our family and in the community. For example, India, I think our Ministry of Health, the Government of India, and our own Prime Minister are having a very strict vigilance on the control and prevention of this particular virus in India. I really want to congratulate them. And I think they have done meticulous measures at the airport as well as the people who are visiting from abroad. Personal hygiene is very important. We all know it, that this particular virus has a preference to stay only for 10 minutes to 12 minutes in the hand. We must have a hand wash for 20 seconds to 40 seconds on the palmar side, dorsal side, and between the fingers. We must keep a distance of 1 meter. From our fellow colleagues as a precaution. This is known as hand hygiene. Then we come to the breathing or respiratory hygiene. We must take care of our nasal hygiene, our mouth hygiene, and we must not sneeze in front of anybody without a handkerchief. We must always use a handkerchief or sneeze on the elbow of the right hand or on the left hand. And this is a very important part as respiratory hygiene. Some people even advise one can do a sore throat gargles with saline in the morning so that they keep a mouth sterile. Third thing is the hygiene in the office. One should make sure that the table where they work or the chair where they work, if it is metallic, porous or non-porous, they are more vulnerable where the virus stays for 8 to 10 hours. In the porous for a less time and non-porous for a longer time. So our objective is it should be nicely, we must have some sanitizer spray over there and wash our hands more often, frequently, at least for about 8 to 10 times. And when we are working in the hospital as a doctor, it's very important we should use a face mask. Especially when you are exposed to a patient who is suffering from some kind of cough or fever, we should always put on a mask. And the patient to whom you are examining should also put on a mask. We must ensure that in every hospital, there is a screening before they enter in the OPD complex or in the emergency complex. Only by checking the temperature or if there is any history of sore throat. So they should be checked. Once you do that, I'm sure things will disappear. And very shortly, in my heart, I know it, that there should not be any fear psychosis. My message is very clear. The message is, no panic, be at ease. Second message is, no panic, be at ease. And third message is, no panic, be at ease. Corona is going to disappear soon. Thank you.
Insights from the world's best medical minds. You are watching TheRightDoctors.com.